بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. The famous dua of Musa alayhi salam on the mountain when he was talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, go to the Pharaoh, the most known and the most powerful person on the earth, go to him and tell him, you're not God, I've been sent from the real God, and Musa alayhi salam is a wanted criminal in Egypt. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him this task, this seemingly impossible task. And you know what's amazing? No prophet was given like their task like this. No prophet was told they're a prophet through Allah. They were told through an angel, like Angel Jibreel alayhi salam told our Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam, Iqra, right? Allah didn't come and say Iqra. Jibreel alayhi salam said Iqra, read to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam. But Allah understood that Musa alayhi salam task is incredibly amazing and hard, so he himself spoke to him alayhi salam. And Musa alayhi salam is actually the most mentioned prophet in the Quran, more than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam. And I think that's because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam in the Quran, right? He's talking to us, but first and forehand, for like quite a few of the ayahs, he's talking to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Like he says, you do this and you do that, right? And he's telling the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, first and foremost, to take examples, like look at Musa alayhi salam's life and understand that you're not the first. You know, when you see someone else with your problem, or not a problem, but you see that they took that task and they overcame it, like they did it, and they were so strong. Don't we get inspired by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was like the president of Medina, but still went on the battlefield and fought? It's such a beautiful dua. So Musa alayhi salam has been given this seemingly impossible task, and what does he say? Rabbi shrahli sadri. Allah, like my Lord, rahli sadri. Open my chest for me. And he says that before he says the next part. Wayasirli amri comes next, which is, and ease my task for me. But first he says, Rabbi shahli sadri. And it's not just for Musa alayhi salam, it's for us. This is in a surah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like talking to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was at a difficult point in his life, a sad point in his life. And he's telling him the story of Musa alayhi salam, Allah is. And Musa alayhi salam make the dua, Rabbi shahli sadri, open my chest for me. That means even if he's standing in front of a ginormous army, because the most powerful man on earth is going to be surrounded by army, right? If he's surrounded by this army and they all have weapons, his chest is at ease. It's open. He can think clearly. He's not going to be scared. So that's the first part of the dua he makes. And then wayasirli amri. He says, make my task easy for me. It is true that Allah says that la yu'adhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim bismillahir rahmanir rahim la yukallifullahu nafsan illa wus'aha. Allah does not burden a soul beyond what it can bear. But some things you can't bear unless you ask Allah for help. So we have to ask Allah for help, and Allah wants us to raise our hands and ask him. How unfortunate is a person who doesn't get to talk to Allah, who doesn't think about Allah, who doesn't have that connection of raising their hand and saying, Ya Allah, I'm in pain. Ya Allah, this happened today. How sad would our life be if we don't get to talk to the one we were meant to talk to? 5 daily prayers to talk to Allah. He calls us 5 times a day and we reject him, don't we? Shaitan rejected one sajda. How many do we reject as Muslims? Okay. We are silly, Amni. Wahlul uqdata min lisani. And untie the knot from my tongue. Now, Some people say that Musa alayhi salam had a stutter, and there is a narration on that. I believe from hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam, there is a narration that he did have a stutter alayhi salam. But it could also not just be literal, it could be like emotional. Like Rabbi Shahli Sadri, when your chest gets tightened, when you're scared, when you have anxiety, what happened? You can't think straight. You can't speak straight. Your words are getting muddled up. And when you say this dua, like I said this dua before making a video last time, and it honestly helped. I had to think less about what I'm saying, and just it has such a beautiful effect. So untie that knot so they can understand. So they may understand me. I want to get my point across. If I'm going to do da'wah to the king of the kings of the earth, not you, Allah, but the king of the earth, like the most powerful man on earth, then I want them to understand me. And if he stutters, then people will think he's scared and he doesn't really know what he's saying, and he doesn't want them to think that. So that's the dua for today. Jazakallah khairan kathir.